I buy them because my daughter loves them. Cherry Pop-Tarts. But when she's gone, they are hard to resist. Resist I will, however, because I need to get fit, and eating a Pop-Tart is never the way to go. Today, I'm learning to navigate the junk food aisle. As a family, my wife and I shared the shopping. I tended to make the runs to the local grocery store on the way home from work. Can I pick something up for dinner? I was that kind of husband. She used to make the Costco runs on the weekends. And God bless her, she'd take the kids. I'd no more want to be in that movie than, well, I'd rather stay home. Probably nap. Staying up late does take its toll on your energy and daytime running lights. And the kids would come back all excited and happy. They usually got a treat of some sort. And there were these huge boxes of foods in the Prius. I'd unload with my wife, and it was all I could do to hold my tongue. Not every time, but at least every other time. She came home with about 40% junk food, the exact shit I was trying to keep from eating. But hey, the kids shouldn't have to go without because I can't control my lust for sugar, right? The kids loved sweet tarts, but we didn't need a 5-pound bag. And fruit roll-ups, sugary sodas, all kinds of popsicles, and, well, you get the idea. And you can't blame her. Going to Costco with kids in tow was a crazy hard task. Maybe if I'd gotten up and played football with them or something. But a trip to Costco was an event they always wanted to join in on, because they could pick out their favorite crap. I recall several times the very next day when I had dinner duty, looking into the pantry and refrigerator and saying to myself, there's not one fucking staple in the house. And I'd go to the local store for some tilapia or chicken. Grr. And it wasn't just the crap the kids ate, it was the crap that was staring me in the face 24/7. You turn down a coconut popsicle at midnight when you're sad, tired, and alone. That part was my fault. I couldn't blame my growing girth on my wife. But goddamn, do we have to fill the house with all this junk food? Halloween, Easter, Christmas, Valentine's. Wasn't that enough? Did our house have to have junk shelves year-round? A funny thing happened as I moved out and had to fend for myself, both in the grocery store and at home. I didn't buy junk food. Sure, I'd get some stuff when the kids were going to be with me for the weekend, and I still do grab Pop-Tarts for them, but I don't fill the house with it. My son asks me to cut him an apple almost every night. Sure, it's a few more steps than grabbing a fruit roll-up, but damn, one of them is actually good for him. Staring at the pile of cherry Pop-Tarts in my pantry in my solo house, I'm tempted, but I have a strategy when shopping with my kids. If they want a treat of junk food, one, I make sure it's something I don't crave. Pop-Tarts are a hit, but I don't like cherry. Perfect. It's my daughter's favorite. Late at night, I have a hard time not ripping into one of the shiny packages of goodness. And every other day until they're gone, I have the same temptation from time to time. I need to learn another discipline, listening to what my body needs. What it needs right now, as I'm trying so many remembrances, is a walk, not another cup of coffee. I love Pop-Tarts. Pop-Tarts don't love me back.